So we're sitting here with
Jennifer
Jenica Reader,
Lauren Hurst,
Rhyme,
Ronnie,
Seb,
Rachel Bureau.
What's your earliest grade 9 memory?
We went for orientation day, or maybe it was just the first day.
I didn't know where to go, and like I didn't know anyone.
So we came in, and it was like the very first day we went to the cast, and you don't know anyone.
And walking in the hallway with like all the older people,
we were like, oh, here's an empty table, like let's sit down.
I feel like when I think of grade 9, all I think of is me like wandering the hallways.
Girl Mandy at the end was like, she was like, leave, like you don't belong.
We were like so scared to get in anybody's way.
And then we went and sat inside.
Laugh. After laugh.
Probably gym.
Gym class. That one time
when we acted like crazy psychos and would do fake fights in the change room to see if people believed it.
Girls are really loud and stuff, like they're weird.
We thought you guys were weird.
Like yeah, but we're probably gonna be friends with them. And then we were.
I feel like we were really judgmental grade 9. I don't know why.
What is your favorite year of high school?
Grade 10.
And I kind of found out who your friends were and
the end of grade 11, like semester 2. Cause that was the when we had the merch break.
But grade 12 went by really fast.
I think grade 11 I did more things. I think that like we went to a lot of more parties and a lot more people were there. Like I guess our friends.
The friend group, everyone was like that's when we really established who our like real friends were and relationships and stuff. And I just feel like
we had the most crazy times. And we just didn't really care what people thought.
You could say you have one crush all of high school. Who is it?
Ultimate crush? It's a tough one. There's a few.
Oh boy. I actually have so many. Okay.
In grade 9, I feel like I didn't even like know what boys were.
We were like grade 9 and they were in the grade 12 and we were like, oh my god, it's so hot.
I don't know him, but when he sweats,
like, he's good looking, he's nice.
Grade 11, I was obsessed with like this one guy.
He was like 4 or 5 years older than us.
Well, I wasn't obsessed, okay? He was just like really cute.
I had a crush on him until he opened his mouth.
What is your favorite party memory?
Party memory, oh my god.
Out back and it was summer and it was people that we weren't really even friends with that were there.
We were at the cottage. It was the only time that it happened and I don't remember it. I don't know, this weekend body shots were a lot of fun. I'm gonna have to admit it. How
does
that sound?
Grade 10 party?
But it's really embarrassing.
Me and Bev, I mean, me and Bev were like outside counting
stars in like different languages.
And then we walked up to the window and we like pressed our faces against the glass. Made like the most retarded face ever. And then we walked inside and realized it was all these
like grade 12 girls and they were like,
and it was the most embarrassing thing ever. And we actually died laughing.
Like I just went in the little closet thing and I was like, oh, laying there. But
we're just like, yes! And like she jumped in my arms, like spun her around, and then we both were, and then I ran with her and we bashed
popcorn all over her basement. Like all over her basement.
Second, I tell her,
hell no!
And like you were in grade 9 and you never really went to parties, and then like you're going for the first time and you it was all new.
What is one thing that you would have done differently?
Maybe I would have tried harder in school.
It was horrible. Just horrible, like academically.
I would have picked classes better.
I'd do grade 9 over again, I think.
I don't know, I don't think I would.
Because I worked and stuff, and honestly, I have no social life.
Maybe try and spend more, like, out there with people kind of thing.
I don't think there's anything that I would really change.
I kind of stuck true to myself, you know what I mean? Like, it was harder to become someone I wasn't because I wasn't around.
Everything that happened leads you to where you are now.
So what is your favorite high school memory?
Prom. Prom, of course. Prom was so much fun. I mean, like prom camping.
Prom camping.
Everyone's dancing.
Quebec.
Riley Week, which was like the best part of the 4 years.
And on Easter, we were lying on Riley's roof.
We did the clap out.
Every single summer.
Like my favorite memories are probably from those years. There's just so many memories in all of them and just look back on them.
If you could describe prom camping in 3 words, what would it be?
Dangerous? I hate rain.
It was wet.
Wet?
It was wet, but it was so fun.
Crazy.
Crazy?
It was crazy.
Tequila.
Belligerent, maybe?
Chaos. People were going nuts.
And it was memorable.
Do you feel like you're growing up too fast?
Yes. Yeah. It makes me sad. Think of how much we grew up and like,
no, I just took things for granted.
No.
I don't think I grew up too that fast, but I think I tried.
I don't even think I've grown up enough.
I'm gonna be this age forever.
20.
I'll stay 20 forever.
I think I'm growing up slower.
I might have wanted to grow up a little faster.
Like you always go, oh well, there's tomorrow. And sitting here right now, like, done grade 12 is scary.
What is one song you think will always remind you of high school?
Beautiful People by Chris Brown.
Either All Summer Long by Kid Rock. Mm-hmm.
I think maybe Fireflies.
Don't Stop Believing.
I think Jai Ho.
Don't Want This Night to End by Luke Bryan.
Summer 69.
I can't pick a song. I can't.
Are you scared for next year?
Honestly, so scared.
Yeah.
I think I'm more excited than nervous though.
I don't want to look at it as fear because I feel like fear is bad.
Yeah.
No, I think I'm more excited than scared.
Well, I'm not going to make any friends.
Because you're leaving, like, everything you've known. It's a huge change.
I'm ready. I think I'm ready.
Is there people that you're really worried you're going to lose touch with?
Yeah. I feel like I'm going to lose touch with a lot of people. If you can't, like, make time to, like, hang out, like, in high school, like, what are you going to do when you don't even live in the same city?
We have our little group of friends.
Yeah.
And we have that.
No, I'm actually going
to
cry.
I just don't want to go.
As much as we're gonna try, it's gonna be really hard.
Just stay in touch with the people.
I feel like everyone loses touch with someone. Everyone's like, I'm excited to leave and stuff. Like, it's exciting, but they're gonna miss it.
I don't wanna grow up. I think sometimes, like, friends are like seasons.
Cause you never know when they're gonna be gone.
You have them in your life for a certain period of time for certain reasons. And then you grow out of friends and you mature and sometimes they don't go with you.
What is one thing you will have liked to accomplish by the time you are 25?
Okay, this sounds really shallow, but I want to be able to, like, make a lot of money.
Have, like, a good job, probably.
Have a job.
Or at least, like, be job searching and going good, I guess.
I think it would be so cool to be part of the Ontario Camp Association.
I want to have a plan for my life.
I'd really like to get an education. I want to get my degree.
Living on my own.
I want to travel.
I want to have a house, whether that's with friends or not with friends.
Have a stable relationship.
If anything, I want to go through Europe backpacking.
Maybe even...
Wait, no, I'm nothing good.
Hopefully be engaged.
Do you want to get married?
Yes.
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 Yeah. Of course.
I don't know.
I really don't know.
It depends on, like, who the person is.
It's gonna either happen or it's not gonna happen.
Yeah, have the whole wedding.
It'd be so fun.
Okay, I wanna be married before 28.
No older than 30.
It'd be nice, but I don't think it's something that's, like, a priority.
If you could give any advice to your 13-year-old self, what would you say?
Just have fun. Like, let things go. I think that's what I would tell myself.
Do your homework.
There's so many things that I wish I didn't take to heart that I kind of did.
Don't make good choices.
Make all the wrong ones.
Boys aren't the end all be all.
Kind of take a step back from what you think you want and recognize what's actually best for you.
So we don't care what people think as much.
There's certain things, when certain things happen, like, you have to remember it's not the end of the world.
Do stuff that makes me happy instead of always trying to make everybody else happy.
I would say not to be so naive about things.
And don't be worried about growing up too fast, because once you're grown up, then you're like, oh my god, I want to be 13 again.
If you had to tell yourself something in 25 years, what advice would you give yourself?
Don't take anything for granted, especially on being happy.
Honestly, just to work hard.
You'll value your family and your health, like, people in your life. Like, I want to make good decisions for me. Don't compromise your happiness.
It's not worth it if you're not happy.
Play it out right.
Don't rush into anything.
Just, like, do whatever you want to do, like, and don't think about it later.
Your life doesn't revolve around boys.
It's hard to say. Everything happens for a reason.
Not to let the little things steal from the big things.